Hi, everyone. I'm Shai from Superblocks. I'm really excited to come to you today to talk about fintech and Superblocks. We're going to be covering a lot today, so let me quickly run through our agenda. So we're going to start by doing a quick product overview of what Superblocks is. For those of you who haven't heard of us, we'll run through some case studies specifically about our fintech customers, and then we'll go ahead and we'll build a fintech app, workflow, and a scheduled job, and then we'll wrap things up. Some coverage of our compliance features, specifically how they relate to fintech. We understand how critical security is, so we support bank level security, and I will be making sure to dig into that in quite some depth later in the video. So what is Superblocks? Superblocks is the only internal tooling platform that is 100% designed for developers. We're not a no-code solution. We're not a low-code solution. We are pro-code, and we want to simplify every step in the software development lifecycle, whether it's building, securing, deploying, monitoring, or querying your databases or SaaS vendors like Equifax or Marketa. With our out-of-the-box integrations, using them, you can build apps, workflows, and set up those scheduled jobs. You can extend our UIs with JavaScript and write business logic with Python. You can secure your tools with granular permissioning, SSO, audit logs, and deploy us out using version control. And like I mentioned, we do integrate with all of these different data stores. We have native database integrations and your standard REST and GraphQL integrations for things that we don't necessarily support. Out of the box, you can still plug them into Superblocks using REST and GraphQL. So the sky's the limit. And in this tough macro climate, Superblocks really accelerates the incredibly painful custom internal software development process, enabling y'all to turn your backend developers into full stack developers without needing them to learn any front end skills. You'll be able to save hundreds of hours on your developer tooling and be able to reallocate those developers back into building core product. You'll be able to save support costs by increasing the efficiency and accuracy of your business teams. And you'll be able to centralize security and management with our permissioning, audit logs, observability, all in one place, rather than having to worry about how many different things do our support teams have access to. All they need is access to Superblocks, and you'll be able to lock it down to specifically what they need based on what they're doing. So let's talk about a few of our customers. Payhawk is already on this page, so I want to dig into them. They're the Brex of Europe, and they run all of their support operations through Superblocks as it relates to credit card management, saving them hundreds of hours. And they'll be one of the demos that we'll be showing off later in the talk. Alchemy is one of the largest Web3 infrastructure providers. As they were scaling during their rapid growth period, they were blocked on invoicing and they lacked analytics. Their developers sat down with Superblocks and put together quite a few internal tools. Now their support teams use Superblocks for user management and all of their business analytics reporting into Slack. Next up, Papaya. They're one of Israel's hottest global payroll companies and payment companies, and they're 800 plus employees strong. Papaya was able to scale during COVID because they built Superblock applications for their operations teams to review, manage, and pay hundreds of third-party in-country partners. Motive, a global fleet management company that serves over 120,000 companies with over 3,000 employees, had a really big problem when it came to launching their new fleet credit card business. They lacked internal tooling. With Superblocks, they were able to launch their business in record time, where all their KYC and credit underwriting happened straight on Superblocks' internal tools. Let's jump into a couple applications that are examples of what our fintech customers are building. We'll be looking at a credit approval application, a workflow for canceling cards, and a scheduled job that alerts for fraudulent transactions. But first off, we're going to start with an application inspired by Payhawk. If you remember Payhawk, one of the customers I mentioned, they manage all of their customer operations through Superblocks, things like canceling, freezing, or adjusting limits on credit cards. And they're using an application in Superblocks pretty similar to this one. They need to view all of their cardholders, filter by status of what's going on, filter by limit, and be able to update all sorts of things. We've gotten a ticket from Kirby, who's one of our customers in here, and Kirby has lost their credit card. So we're able to quickly search for them in this application and request a new one in just one click. We filter to the customer and we're going to click this cancel and issue new card. It's going to pop them out and we'll be able to provide a reason why the card is being canceled. We can confirm their shipping address and leave any internal notes for our customer team. There we go. We can hit cancel. And now it's updated on our status board that it's been canceled and we'll be able to close the Zendesk ticket. And we have the updated information. And if we wanted to adjust their limit, we could do that just as easily, or even just freeze their card just as easily. Next up is the credit card management application. So it's a credit card approval application that we built as a demo for one of our fintech customers. One developer at Superblocks built this in an afternoon. It's using Python, JavaScript, Postgres, and a whole bunch of different APIs that connect to things like Persona, Aloy for KYC status, Equifax, and TransUnion for underwriting. And let's take a look at some of the stuff going on here. So I can really quickly sort and filter based on all sorts of parameters. I can pull for only folks that have passed credit checks. I can click into here and easily get a pop out with all of the information that I need. So I'm pulling their driver's licenses from our database. I'm getting their status checks from Persona and Aloy by making rest calls, underwriting from Equifax and TransUnion. And I'm really easily able to reject or approve an application. So let's say this person is going to go ahead and we'll approve them. Let's say looks good. I can go ahead and say that they passed all their checks, hit submit. And then when we scroll down here and the page refreshes, we will see the documentation and the history of the thing that I just approved and the note. So we're able to keep track of it, have the auditing information, and do all sorts of things that we need with this. Let's go ahead and jump into behind the scenes with what's going on here. So I'm able to make all sorts of changes to this dashboard. So Superblocks is a drag and drop kind of application when it comes to the front end. So I can drag and drop all of these things. I can push out this slider and pick from all sorts of additional components and add to it really, really quickly. And what we're doing here to populate this table is we're calling this main table object inside of these double curlies. Anytime you see double curlies in Superblocks, that means you have the capacity to do full JavaScript. We could write a whole bunch of functional code in here, but all we're doing is we're taking the main table object that we're generating in our backend and then kind of filtering down to the specific thing that we need to render this table. And we're able to do all sorts of customization to this table. So we aren't showing everything that's here. We're only showing the stuff that a support agent needs to see at a quick glance. And then when you click into one of these tables, we're able to pass along the selected table row and use it to make this look like it's a custom thing for this specific person, which is really powerful. Now, let's take a look at how we're getting this data. So over here in this table, we're getting this data from main table. So I'm going to pull up the Superblocks backend with command U, or we could have just clicked this little button here. And so this area is kind of the Superblocks backend. So you're able to very quickly add all of your integrations and start building functions out. And it's kind of sequentially done. So this is our main table function that we're using to build that table. It runs on page load and you can configure that. It's triggered by a bunch of things. And we could also add timers to it if we wanted. But let's take a look at what's going on here. So first off, we're getting a list of all of the formatting options. So we've got these filters up here in the front end. And so we're grabbing the filters. We're specifically grabbing this applicant dropdown. So if we wanted to type someone's name and filter by a specific person, we'd be able to do that. And we're going to use that to dynamically create a SQL query. So we're going to pass this PRE format dropdown options into the SQL query. And then when we run it, if there's something there, we'll get a specific thing with a person. If there's not, it'll just ignore the where clause. And we can take a look at what SQL gets executed right here. Then we're going to pull a KYC and credit check. Here we're using Mockeroo since we want to make sure that we're getting consistent data in our demos. But realistically, this would be using the Marketa API or the Persona API. Mockeroo is just a nice thing that lets you kind of simulate REST endpoints. And we're getting a whole bunch of data back from this. And it's coming with all sorts of user IDs. So we're very quickly able to write a Python function that's going to merge all of these things together. So we're going to take the data we got from get applicants, and you can see it right here. And then we're going to merge it with our get KYC output from this previous step. And then we'll return it as an array of or a dictionary with two specific things that we're able to select. So in the main table, we're going to pick the pending applications. And then in the second table, we'll pick the reviewed applications. And this will all get rendered out, which is really helpful. Now, when I'm happy with this application, I can deploy it really quickly just by hitting click and hit deploy. And I can view it with just view deployed applications. And something I really like is that I can view the version. So something I did earlier today is I changed one of our tables to take advantage of our tags feature. You can see here that we've got these little tags now. So it looks really nice and we've made it a little different. And so I have my comment on what I've done. We can see exactly who did it, and we can easily revert back to a previous version. Let's say no one likes this, or I've broken something, I can roll back with redeploy or even just jump straight into the edit mode if I need to, which is really useful. So next up, I want to show you a workflow. So if you remember in that credit application from before, we canceled a credit card. So we used a workflow to do that. Now, workflows are really cool. They're one of my favorite features at Superblocks. They're basically REST APIs running on a Superblocks endpoint. Think of them as like Zapier, but for developers. So you can customize them entirely with code and get an endpoint back. And so you can use both of these inside and outside of Superblocks. So we used it inside to cancel a credit card, and now we can go ahead and use it outside of Superblocks. And we can take a quick look here at what we're doing. So we're going to grab the address based on the customer ID. We're going to terminate their card. Again, I'm using Mockeroo to simulate this, and then we'll issue a new card through Marqeta, again, using Mockeroo to simulate it. And then we'll shoot an email to our customer, and we're able to put full HTML in the email. So I'm going to go ahead and trigger this. We're going to have it use me. I need to cancel my credit card. I'm very easily able to scroll down and get an example curl request. So let's go ahead and copy paste this curl request into my terminal. And then I'm going to pipe it through JQ, which is just a JSON formatter. So it looks nice. It's going to make that curl request. And you can see that it's giving us all sorts of metadata, things like the response. And then it's also showing us that we've sent that email. And now if I pull my email up, I should have a new email in there. And yep, here it is. Let me drag it right over on screen. You can see 1154, 1155. So that email just showed up, and I've got an alert that it's coming to my fake house in Texas in 6 to 7 days. And I've got my number so I can, you know, get information if I need to about the application. Okay, so that's workflows. I really like them. What I like even more is scheduled jobs. So scheduled jobs are like cron jobs running on Superblocks. So here's a really fun scheduled job. We have it set up to run every Monday, Wednesday, Friday at 12 a.m. And what it's going to do is it's going to pull all of our transactions from our SQL database. It's going to hit a fraud API, and it's going to provide a list of all the fraud that's happened in the last period. It's going to merge those two data sets together, and then it's going to process them so they look like what Slack needs. So Slack has a bunch of APIs, and they request that you give them data in a specific format. So we're going to build that format for them and document it, and then we're going to make a REST call to Slack. And if I hit run, it's going to show up in our Slack. So let me hit run to test it. And I'm going to pull our Slack over so you can see it. Here we go. There's Slack. And you can see we just made a new post of recently flagged transactions. So it's showing us all of the fraudulent transactions. And if we scroll up, we can see that this has actually been triggering every Monday, Wednesday, Friday at 12 a.m. So let's take a look at some of the compliance features that Superblocks has. We can head back into the Superblocks application, and we can go and take a look at our audit logs. So from the homepage, I can just click straight into audit logs right here. And I have a history of every action that has taken place in my internal application. I can see all the applications, workflows, and scheduled jobs, their full execution history. I can use these audit logs to really quickly identify errors in the application. It's a really great tool for troubleshooting any API errors, especially things that might be running without user input, like scheduled jobs or workflows. But more importantly, I can use these audit logs to track all my sensitive events, so I can take advantage of that for compliance purposes. I have this global view where I can see all of my sensitive applications and who's doing things with them. Let's take a look at this permissions section. So I click on permissions, and I can see that we've got a whole bunch of groups. So we've got role-based access control built straight into Superblocks. We're able to see who is specifically in groups. We're able to create new ones if we need to. And we can specifically go ahead and add certain groups to certain applications and certain data sets. So if I want to limit our credit card application that we just built, the credit approval application, I can go ahead and lock that down. So I can make it so, you know, only invited users can access it. But we can say that support here are the only people that can build on it. And we can say maybe they only want to view it. So we can do that too and restrict them down as well really, really easily. Next up is SSO and on-prem. So let's take a look at that really quickly. So with Superblocks, we have an on-premise agent. So we can make sure that all of your customer data stays inside your network. You deploy this agent yourself, so you can do it in 5 minutes with Docker or Kubernetes, and you'll always have an up-to-date platform because you'll be reaching out to the Superblocks cloud to get RUI and to take care of authentication. So all of the updates that we make to Superblocks, you will get just your jobs and your job execution will be running on the agent inside of your network. It's open source, so if you need to audit it or extend it, you can do that really quickly, and it's performant and scalable that you can do on your own side. And we also support SSO, things like Google SSO, Okta, Custom SAML, and any sort of OpenID providers. And Superblocks is also SOC 2 compliant, and you can reach out to us if you want our full SOC 2 report. There's information on how to get that full SOC 2 report in our documentation as well if you want to see it. So that's pretty much it for me today. I'm Shai from Superblocks, and do reach out to us if you have any questions. Feel free to shoot me an email if you need any help. And if you attend any of our webinars live, we're able to hook you up with a t-shirt. So do keep an eye on our Twitter account if you want to grab a Superblocks t-shirt. We'd be happy to hook you up sometime in the future. That's it for me today. And thank you all for your time. I'll talk to you all soon. Bye.